that point, Meghana, Amulya, Pooja Shah, Vishnuvardhan. We work under the guidance of our mentor, Dr. K. Parvathalu sir, Assistant Professor of Physics. I'm here to explain the introduction of Marangoni flow. This is a visual of Marangoni flow. Let's know about the background of Marangoni flow. This was first identified in the tears of wine. These are the visuals of tears of wine. This is first identified by physician Thompson in 1855. In this visual, the viscosity. Actually, the viscosity is a measure of the fluids and the resistance to flow. And we all know that water's viscosity is less. But when we add surfactant to the water, what happens? It slowly increases as a function of aerobic concentration, which might be influenced on the flow's. Here you can see density. Actually, the density of substances is its mass by value. But when we add surfactant to the water, what happens? It gradually increases as a function of aerobic concentration, which might be influenced on the both the flows. One is paramagnetic flow and the other is spontaneous flow. Here we have surface tension. As we all know that surface tension of water is much higher, which is about 70 newton per meter. But when we add surfactant to the water, what happens? You know, it gradually decreases as a function of aerobic concentration, which might be influenced on the both the flows. In this case, the injection of oil molecules into the aerobic solution will drive a force and transfer their energy into the layers of vesicles. And these layers are destabilized and leads to explode and create the second flow. Now my friend Pooja Shah will continue the remaining part. Thank you.
Continue. Twice.